हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे माय टॉपिक इज द 100 ड्रेसेस वन। हियर देयर आर मेनी कैरेक्टर्स बट सम इम्पॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टर्स आर देयर लाइक पेगी, मैडी एंड ऑब्वियसली वंडा पेट्रॉन्स्की। इन दिस पार्ट वन वी विल रीड अबाउट हाउ द चिल्ड्रन इन द स्कूल यूज्ड टू टीच द न्यू गर्ल केम टू अमेरिका, दैट इज वंडा पेट्रॉन्स्की। Actually, she is a Polish girl. She came to America and she was immigrants of Poles, and therefore she was not ideally accepted in the classroom condition. She was teased and asked several questions, especially by Peggy. And the reply every time that was, I have 100 dresses, that was given by Wanda Petrovsky. Here, guilt, conscience of Maddie. Actually, Peggy was belonging to a very rich family and she was having a good intelligence. In spite of that, she did not fail to ask Wanda Petrovsky some question repeatedly, the same question every day. And this asking question by Peggy as well as by other classmates made a feel of guilt in the mind of Maddie. She was feeling insult by herself also, because she did not like asking Wanda Petrovsky the same question every day. Here, after some time, you can see there was a painting competition, especially dresses designs were themed for the girls. In this category, Wanda Petrovsky, the silent girl, showed her talent and potential. She won the 100 dress competition and she achieved the first prize. Here, three main topics are there in this part one, 100 dresses one, like humiliation of Wanda Petrovsky. Second one, guilt conscience of Maddie, and painting competition owned by Wanda. First of all, when the story starts, that time you can see there was absence of a girl. The name of the girl is Wanda Petrovsky. She was not coming to school for some days. Beforehand, she was getting insult every day. It was like a humiliation for her of asking the same question, the things she did not have. She was asked the question, how many dresses she had and how many shoes she had. And the answer of these questions were the same, that she had 60 pair of shoes and she had 100 dresses or lineup. She was silent, but she was feeling insult and guilt inside. She conveyed all the matters to her father because she did not have mother. On the other hand, you can see guilt of conscience. Maddie, the friend of Peggy, she was also not feeling good of asking the same question every day, especially by her close friend, that is Peggy. And she was bothered. And here in this chapter, the central character is Maddie, because she is only one character. She is leading the total plot of the story. And she is also feeling sad for the girls who had left the school forever, that is Wanda Petrovsky. And eventually, when the painting competition was over and it was the day for the announcement of the winner, that day it came to be known that Wanda Petrovsky achieved or got the first prize in the painting competition because she had drawn 100 pictures of beautiful paintings, especially of different designs of the clothes and dresses, all of different colors combinations, and all are looking gorgeous. Even a single painting is capable of winning the prize, where she had painted 100 dresses design. The 100 dresses is a 1944 children's book, so it is related to the year of 1944. It is a children's book by Eleanor Estes, illustrated by Louis Slovakin. The book centers on Wanda Petrovsky. Like, the plot of this story is centering around or revolving around Wanda Petrovsky. Who was Wanda Petrovsky? She was a poor and friendless Polish American girl. She was Polish and came to America, and she was lonely. Her teacher, outwardly kind, puts her in the odd seat in the schoolroom or last bench of the classroom, and does not intervene when her schoolmates tease her mercilessly. One day, after her classmates laugh at her funny last name and the faded blue dress she wears to school every day, Wanda claims to own 100 dresses all lined up in her closet. Closet is a cupboard. This outrageous and obvious lie becomes a game. Everybody was expecting that Wanda Petrowski was telling lies because she didn't have 100 dresses. So this became a monotonous game of every day, as the girls in her class corner every day, her every day before school, waiting for her to tease, demanding that she describe for them all her dresses. Wanda ends up leaving school. So this is the feature. This was the ending. She left the school and moving to the city. So she decided to go to the another city. After she has moved, a dress design competition at school reveals that she was indeed telling the truth. She had the 100 dresses, but in the form of the painting. Her winning entry consists of beautiful, detailed drawing of 100 dresses, each exactly as she had described. Her tormentors were awed by the artistic talent. Everybody became surprised. But the story is not about Wanda. It is told from the point of view of her classmate Maddie, who feels bad for Wanda but is nevertheless particularly mean to her because she herself is poor and does not want to be the target of her wealthier peers. By writing sympathetically and from the viewpoint of someone complicit in the social violence, the story confronts readers to question their own attitude and behavior. Here, the Polish immigrants came from Poland to America, and it was a very poor community and was discriminated for their style in the United States. Actually, people of America did not tolerate these people who came from other country. And today we are going to read this chapter of 100 Dresses. The story was written in 1944 and published in the same. It is a sensitive account of how a poor girl is judged by her classmates. The name of the girl is Wanda Petrowski. She is a young Polish girl who goes to school with other Americans in an American town. These other children see Wanda different in many ways, such as she was poor, she was from another country, she has a funny name, she doesn't have mother, she always wears the same faded dress. But when asked, how many dresses do you have, Wanda? She will always answer, 100, all lined up. Here, from the rest of the portion, we will continue. Like, this is the beginning of the part 1, 100 Dresses 1. Here it is told that today, Monday, Wanda Petrowski was not in her seat, but nobody, not even Peggy and Madeline, the girls who started all the fun, noticed her absence. So, whether she was coming to school or not, nobody was paying attention to Wanda Petrowski, because in the classroom 13, she was negligible, she was neglected and segregated. Therefore, she was not observed by any other girls that she was not coming for some days. Usually, Wanda sat in the seat next to the last seat in the last row of the room number 13. exactly at the back side of the room, room number 13, she was sitting every day. She sat in the corner of the room where the rap boys. So here you can see she was sitting in the last row, and it was the room number 13. She sat every day. Room number 13, she sat in the corner of the room where the rap boys who did not make good marks sat. So this is the last bench where some notorious or bad boys are sitting. For they are not getting good marks, the corner of the room where there was most scuffling of the feet, means rubbing of the feet with the floor, and the sound of scuffling is coming. Most roars of laughter when anything funny was said. So most of the laughter and shouting is coming from the last bench where anything was told very funny at the time. And most mud and dirt on the floor also. So it is not like a good place. It was a bad place, dirty place, the last bench where Wanda Petrovsky used to sit. Wanda did not sit there because she was rough and noisy. So here it is not the reason that she was a bad girl. She was noisy, she was bad. On the contrary, she was very quiet and rarely said anything at all. She was not saying any word to anything else. She was very silent, sober. And nobody had ever heard her laugh out loud. Actually, her sound, her words and speaking was not heard by many people. Sometimes she twisted her mouth into a crook sort of smile, but that was all. Sometimes if she started laughing, that is not open mouth laughing, it was only gentle smile she gives. Nobody knew exactly why Wanda sat in the seat, unless it was because she came all the way from Boggin side. Here, students, you can read this part because this is the place where she lived. Nobody knew exactly why Wanda sat in the last seat. Actually, there was no reason. Actually, no one knows what is the reason for sitting in the last row or the last bench, unless it was because she came from all the way from Boggin side and her feet were usually cracked with dry mud. And that was the reason, maybe because she was feeling guilty and shame, for she was coming from a bad place. The name of the place was not good at all, like Boggin side. And she used to come to school barefooted without having any slippers or footwears. So some dry mud used to stuck with her feet, and that made the floor dirty. But no one really thought much about Wanda Petrovsky once she sat in the corner of the room. Nobody was paying attention, nobody was thinking about her while she was sitting in the corner of the room. The time when they thought about Wanda was outside the school hours. So when the school was over, that time only the students pay attention to her, because this time was the ideal time for asking her several questions and the same question every day. Let's see what happened after that. At noon time, when they were coming back, to school, or in the morning before school began, when groups of two or three or even more would be talking and laughing on their way to the schoolyard. So it is the time before the beginning of the classes. In some places, many girls are standing together, they are talking and laughing about something else. Then sometimes they waited for Wanda also, these girls of the school, and to have fun with her. The next day, Tuesday, Wanda was not in school. So Monday she was absent, and even the next day she was absent too. The time when they thought about Wanda was outside school hours. And even you can see the Tuesday, the next day also she did not appear in the school. And at the time, then sometimes they waited for Wanda to have fun with her. The next day, Tuesday, Wanda was not in the school either. Nobody noticed her absence again. Nobody was knowing whether she is coming to coming to school or not. But on Wednesday, it was the third day, Peggy and Maddie, who sat down front with other children who got good marks and who did not track in the whole lot of mud, did notice that Wanda was not there. On third day, Peggy and Maddie noticed that Wanda is not coming for 3 days. Peggy was the most popular girl in the school. She was pretty, looking nice, she had many pretty clothes, and her hair was curly. This was the style of features of Peggy was given. She was nice looking, she had many pretty clothes, means nice clothes. Her hair is also curly, and Maddie was her closest friend. Who was Maddie? Maddie was her closest friend. The reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Wanda's absence was because Wanda had made them late to school. Actually, on third day, on Wednesday, why did they notice that Wanda was not coming? Because they were waiting for Wanda to come and ask her the same question. But when on the third day she did not appear for the school, so it might be that they made late to come to school for waiting for Wanda Petronsky. On Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, who sat down front with other children who got good marks and who did not track in the whole lot of mud, and did notice that Wanda was not there, and Peggy was. So here Peggy was, and Peggy and Maddie, while they were coming to school, there was no mud on their feet, only clean feet were there. She was so here detail of Peggy was given. She was a nice girl, her clothes, she had many clothes, and her hair is also curly. Maddie was her closest friend, and the reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Wanda's absence was because Wanda had made them late to school. They had waited for Wanda to have some fun with her, and she just had not come on the third day also. They often waited for Wanda Petronsky to have fun with her. That was the scenario. But eventually, she did not appear for the third day also. Let's proceed to the next section. And Wanda Petronsky, most of the children in the room number 13 did not have names like that. Actually, what is the reason for making fun with that girl? Wanda Petronsky was a very unique name, and nobody had name like that, and they had names easy to say. Like the children or the girls in the school especially like the names that are easily pronounced, like Thomas, Smith, Allen. There was one boy named Bounce, Willie Bounce. The people thought that was funny, but not funny in the same way as Petronsky, because the name was very odd looking, especially Wanda Petronsky. One name was given, Willie Bounce, but that name was not so much funny as Wanda Petronsky. Wanda did not have any friends. She came to school alone and went home alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that did not hang right. So in this way you can see dress up of Wanda Petronsky was not good. She was wearing the same dress every day, like blue faded dress. This was the dress was cleaned, but it was not ironed, not hung properly. It was clean, but it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. She did not have any friends, but a lot of girls talked to her. Sometimes they surrounded her in the school yard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch on the worn hard ground. Hopscotch, one type of traditional game like kit-kit. And here in the school yard, when the children or girls especially, they are playing hopscotch, that time sometimes Wanda Petronsky used to come and stood there and watch their play. And it was the ideal time for because she came out and all the children got her alone, and that time you can see how they are making fun out of her. Like Wanda, Peggy would say in the most courteous manner, as though she were talking to Miss Masson. Like she was talking, here Miss Masson was their teacher, and Peggy was talking in such a way that she was talking to teacher. Wanda, she would say, giving one of her friends a nudge. Nudge means push. And she gave a little push to one of her friends and asked once again, Wanda, tell us, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? The reply would come, 100. 100, Wanda would say. 100, exclaimed all the little girls incredulously, means unbelievingly. All are telling, 100 you have? The little ones would stop playing hopscotch and listen. Yeah, 100, all line up, said Wanda. Then her thin lips drew together in silence. Means no more telling of answer is there. She became silent. So in this part, I am completing this one up to this. In my next video, I will come and cover up the remaining portion till the end. Okay, all of you, take care of yourself. Goodbye.